This is why you don't drive metal into trees. Please don't put metal in trees. This is a piece of a cable that the tree grew around. I heard a little clink when the blade hit it. Not sure you can even hear me with the saw running, but these will be the logs that will be used most likely for the 12-foot walls. When I get these to the yard at home, first thing I'll do is come back and peel all of this bark off. You can see that light brown there? That's a cambium layer that has to come off of there. You don't want to leave the cambium layer on your logs. That's what bugs will go underneath that and lay their eggs. Now you may live in an area where you don't have to worry about that, but here in the southern states, we have the wood borer problem, and we get the bark and the cambium layer off just as soon as we possibly can. eliminate the bugs from laying their eggs underneath that. I'm anxious to have these at the house and on some sawhorses. Howdy y'all, Bearded Carpenter here. Just got through unloading the first load of logs and it's wet. We had an inch and a half of rain yesterday and this is the only level place we've got on these hills and it's just a little mucky around here, but we were able to get this load off. Got probably three more loads to haul that's already sawed, but I'm getting pretty excited about getting these logs here and getting them peeled and getting on the cabin build. Just hang in there, we're going to have some fun.